It's your boy and Guru in the house, back with another bang on video. But ladies and gentlemen, more news for you guys. Well, transfer window is definitely coming very close the next month itself, but the news are really pouring in to one too many. A lot of players being linked with Arsenal, a lot of new challenges coming up Arsenal's way. Will Arsenal triumph? Will Arsenal sign a new player or not this January transfer window? We got you covered. Every news will be covered, and of course, we're going to be live every single day, 7:30 p.m. Indian Standard Time. So, mark your calendars, set your alarms, and definitely set your reminders, because we will be covering the transfer window once again. But more importantly, let us talk about the first of all, we don't actually have time to discuss about something else. Let's straight away jump into the first news. Arsenal and Wolves are among the clubs eyeing move for Maxi Gomez. Now, he is a striker who plays for Valencia. Wonderful striker, but it looks like Valencia are ready to sell the striker in January or summer, but he has a release clause of £125 million. £125 million, ridiculous release clause. But good news, it looks like Valencia will sell him for a less amount of money. Arsenal and Wolves are among the clubs monitoring developments with Valencia striker Maxi Gomez. The Uruguayan international only joined from Celta Vigo in 2019, but is expected to be sold either in January or summer as Valencia look to raise funds. Now, the 24-year-old has a buyout clause of £125 million, but Valencia will consider offers for considerably less as they look to keep the club afloat amid the financial ramifications that the pandemic has at them. Now, what? I think he has 19 caps for Uruguay and has scored 3 goals this season in 10 appearances after notching 11 last term. The statistics do not suggest that he is prolific. He is highly regarded as one of the best forwards in Spain and a regular recognized threat inside the box. If Arsenal can make it, I don't know, but they have an eye on him. But also, let's talk about more stuff. Pablo Mari. Yes, Pablo Mari has come out in staunch support of Mikel Arteta. Pablo Mari recently opened up about Arteta. He says, "The first thing is that I think that quick coach changes are not the right thing to do. When you sign a coach, it's because he has given you the confidence that his idea of football is the one that you think is the best for your club. When you want to change a dynamic or a mentality of a club, it is difficult to do it in a month. But Mikel, I think the idea of the club has changed. The attitude, the mentality has changed. I go with Mikel until the end of the world. He just needs time." So, you know what? He said, I go with Mikel until the end of the world. He just needs time. That raises a lot of things, man. I love it. Love to hear it from Pablo Mari. But more importantly, let's talk about Gabriel Martinelli. He actually had some minutes for the Arsenal under-21s yesterday in the Papa John's trophy that they lost. But the game lost. But this is what he tweeted out, Gabriel Martinelli. "It was a great feeling to get minutes tonight. Huge thanks to the medical and physio teams, Arsenal for their fantastic work, and to the fans for their amazing support during my long recovery." Prince, come back to the Premier League where you belong, bro. But let's talk about more stuff. Arsenal have wrapped up first place in the Europa group stages and will be seeded for the next round draw. The Gunners will find out their last 32 opponents next week at noon on Monday, December 14th. Remember, December 14th is a draw. They will be drawn, and Red Star Belgrade are the only confirmed unseeded team going into Thursday's games. 4 of the third place Champions League teams will be unseeded, which may include Manchester United, which they are actually. So let's see how things change, because the games will be coming up in February 18th and 25th. So round of 32 is really far away from us now. But moving on, Glenn Hoddle has discussed why he thinks Arsenal are suffering with a defence not good enough to carry out Mikel Arteta's plans. He says, "They are playing some decent football, but their cutting edge has gone, and I always feel they are vulnerable defensively. I do not think their defenders are good in 1v1s when they leave themselves in those situations. They get caught out. There is a hell lot of work that Mikel has to do. I think they play from the back too much at times. It is okay doing that at Manchester City when you have a fabulous goalkeeper with his feet and you have bought players for millions who can cope with playing out from your own six-yard box. To go to Arsenal, they're not ready to do it as a team and you can pick them off. So they are putting a lot of pressure on themselves. However, it looks like Arsenal may not live to thank RB Leipzig for knocking Manchester United in the Europa League, because the odds of winning the next Europa League, well, the highest are Manchester United 5-1, Tottenham are 6-1, Arsenal are 7-1, Leicester 10-1, Milan 10-1, and Napoli 12 bar 1. However, PM Rick Aubameyang has been fined £7,500 for his complaints at the Confederation of African Football last month. Well, we all know what had happened. A number of social media posts, including pictures of pals sleeping on the floor and tweets tagging the CAF, were deemed to have trashed the organization's honor and image. One post read, "Nice job, CAF. It's as if we were back in 1990s. The Gambia's FA have also been fined 75,000, half of which is suspended. Well, also, a survey of Premier League fans have revealed that Arsenal are seen as the most likely to hammer their own side. Well, that is according to Footy Accumulator's Top Flight Trades poll taken by 2,000 supporters of top-tier clubs. It showed Arsenal supporters were rated as most likely to leave a game early, boo their own team and bet against their own team. Did you know that? But by contrast, Wolves were seen as the least likely to boo or bet against their teams, with Leicester fans are just most keen to stay until the end. Well, it's up to them. However, well, it looks like Arsenal's interest in Franck Kessié is short-lived, because according to Calcio Mercato, it looks like AC Milan are in talks to extend his contract post 2022. Now, 2022 is when his contract ends. So Kessié had declared earlier in the season saying, "I never even thought of leaving Milan, and no one in the club has ever asked me. Wearing this shirt, which I now consider like a second skin, is a pride for me and for my whole family." Coming of age, the midfielder. But Didier Deschamps believes Patrick Vieira is definitely being sacked by Nice, but he has got it to bounce back again. Deschamps said, "It's always a tough time, even though it's early in his career. He has sufficiently broad shoulders, character, the adventure in Nice ends. It is that there is inevitability over the lack of results, but I have no doubt that he will bounce back. He has everything to be a good coach." Now, if it's coming from Didier Deschamps, believe it. You better believe it. Now, Mikel Arteta has reportedly been given 3 games to save his Arsenal job, according to Calcio Mercato. They claim that Edu Gaspar is ready to axe Mikel Arteta if results do not improve. And Juventus boss Massimiliano Allegri has apparently been lined up to take his position at Emirates. I do not believe them. But moving on, well, here are some training picks for you guys. Emil Smith Rowe alongside Ainsley Maitland-Niles, because we know it is a Europa League game. We are definitely going to see both of them. I think against Dundalk, we can see both of them start as easily. Nicolas Pepe, another starter for tomorrow against Dundalk. And then there's Granit Xhaka. And of course, Emil Smith Rowe and Willian actually being a part of this. And Kieran Tierney. You can always see Kieran Tierney. Mikel Arteta, Shkodran Mustafi, Dani Ceballos with Mo Elneny. Well, of course, they're happy. They're happy, right? And Kieran Tierney, Callum Chambers, and Hector Bellerin, Granit Xhaka, Gabriel, and of course, Rob Holding. All of them in one frame, captured by the Arsenal photographers. And of course, the players alongside Cedric Soares, Alex Lacazette, being part of that training. And not only that, you can see Bukayo Saka being part of it as well, Cedric and Callum Chambers. I think I could see Callum Chambers get some minutes this game, the Dundalk game. Let's see. And you have Gabriel and Folarin Balogun, one of the expected starters tomorrow. However, we talk about the next winger being linked with Arsenal. If you don't know this guy, he plays for Bayer Leverkusen. His name is Leon Bailey. Now, scouts from Arsenal, Tottenham, Everton and Manchester United will be watching Leon Bailey on Thursday night as they assess a summer move for Bayer Leverkusen winger. But it looks like the Bayer Leverkusen winger is up for grabs, and it looks like a lot of potential suitors are in the mix, especially Man United, Tottenham, Everton and Arsenal. Let's see. I would love to have him, but it'd be super expensive. However, PSG have been warned by Arsene Wenger not to buy Lionel Messi. He says, "Those who will replace Cristiano Ronaldo and Messi are already at PSG. It's a question of balance in the club, a technical balance and a financial balance. Can you keep this balance at PSG by bringing in players like Messi? I am not sure." So he's definitely not sure of Messi to make it in Paris Saint-Germain. But financially, it actually does not, it's not easy to balance the books, because this guy earns a fortune, man. However, let's talk about it. Gabriel Magalhães Congratulations to Gabriel because he's been named Arsenal Player of the Month for third consecutive month. Yes, imagine the best player in the pitch for Arsenal voted by you guys, and Arsenal is a defender, which tells us a lot about Arsenal's attack. It's literally dead. That's what it tells me. I don't know about you guys, but Sun Sports' David Seeger writes, Mikel Arteta can hide behind a thinly veiled layer of positivity all he wants, but he must know Arsenal are seriously struggling. After all, the table does not lie, and the Gunners sit 15th after the 2-0 North London Derby loss against Tottenham. Arteta needs to take a long, hard look at his tactics and find something that works before this weekend's clash with Burnley. While Dundalk may not provide the sternest test in Thursday night's Europa League draw, the boss could and should use the trip to experiment. Will the boss use the trip to experiment? Only the boss knows, and we will know once we watch the games. Well, these were the news of the day. I hope you enjoyed whatever came your way. All the views and news and everything about Arsenal comes to this platform every single day twice. So what you got to do is subscribe and hit the bell icon. I will see you in the next one. Do not forget, join in the live tomorrow, 7:30 p.m. And also, send in your predicted 11. Use my lineup 11, lineup 11, whatever it is, or createformation.com. Create your formation. Send me the images of those on my Instagram DMs or Twitter. Follow me while you are there as well. And of course, cheers. I'll see you in the next one.